So what we're doing today is we're doing a little bit more manipulation of an advanced movement with Gua Sha. So first what I do is I milk the lymph. And because your lymph nodes are more prominent here and behind here, I'm going to focus on actually going up with my thumbs, holding with my finger, going up towards the ear. You're directly on the SCM muscle, and then you're moving down. So we're going up, and then moving down. Now these are more advanced movements, so this takes a little time to get used to. But once you do this about 3 to 5 times, then you can move your fingers to the underneath the chin, the submental. So we're going to pull towards us with our fingers, and then we're going to push with our thumbs, overlapping our thumbs directly under the chin area. Pull, and then we're going to push. You can do this 3 to 5 times. Now I personally do this before I do my Gua Sha stones, because it's like a prep for the skin and the lymph. And when I use my Gua Sha stones, it just gives it that added flush and added push so that it drains really well to the right and left subclavian vein. And then once I go here, I'm gonna go to the masseter area and I'm going to lift and lift with my thumbs, holding my fingers at the temple. And then I'm gonna go across and lift and lift, and then work on the underneath the zygomatic, pushing towards the ear, and lift under the zygomatic, and push under the zygomatic. Then I'm gonna make little strokes right at the ball of the cheek, going up, going up, going up, taking my thumbs where they're parallel, going up, up, up. That's called the quadraticus levator. And then we're going to push across the zygomatic and give it a nice pump of a roll with your thumbs at the temple. Then I'm going to take my thumb and go underneath the eyes and push and roll. Push and roll, push and roll. I'm going to take my index finger and my middle finger and I'm going to pump, 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 and then actually roll my fingers from the middle to the end, middle, top portion of the forehead, middle to the end. Again, your fingers are parallel. You're going to push down, pump 3 times. Take your fingers, transition index to middle. Move down behind the ear to the right and left. And then pump 3 times. 1, 2, 3. So now we're going to transition to our Gua Sha stones. So it is very important that your movements, that you do at least 5 to 10 passes for complete lymph drainage to the right and left subclavian vein and be able to pump into the thoracic and the right arm duct. So when we're doing this, we're working behind the ear, resting on the mastoid process, okay? So when you're taking your Gua Sha stones, you're going to use the flat end. Put that right up against that bone, and you're going to move down behind the SCM muscle, in front of the SCM muscle, and pump 3 times. 1, 2, 3. We're going to repeat this at least 5 to 10 times, depending on your client's congestion or inflammation. Ear. 1, 2, 3. Repeat. when you're in the process of doing the movement, do not lift, okay? Keep contact with the skin because you want to really emphasize that complete movement with the lymph vessels. Because remember, lymph is moved by muscle contraction, by your breath, and by the arterioles. So you want to make sure that you keep that process of moving that lymph constantly. And this, again, is going to help eliminate waste fluid that the cell might have, as well as CO2 from the cell. So that does that respiration exchange. And it also wants to, it also helps with overall health around the cell's environment. So you just keep moving so that the cell can bathe in the lymph in order to protect the cell's environment. As we move up, we're going to go from jawline to jawline, underneath the jawline, and we're going to bring it down. Now, because the lymph vessels are so surface to the skin, we don't need to make a firm pressure. We don't want to collapse the lymph vessel or the capillaries, because all of that's important to make the lymph move. So we're just doing a nice, even movement, consistent, fluid, all the way down above the clavicle to palm. Jawline to behind the ear. So we're going to hold here and we're going to smooth. You see how I'm smoothing out? Then I'm going to transition behind the ear and then pump. 1, 2, 3. Now, what's great about lymph movement is that if someone is in a sympathetic nervous state, which means that they're keyed up, and they're a little bit stressed, this moving lymph helps to bring the body back to a balance of a parasympathetic neuro state. So it's very good. And again, 5 to 10 movements, that's not too much when you're moving lymph manually and trying to release a lot of the additional fluid, inflammation, whatever the case may be. And then we're going to go up. We're going to flip where the large point is up and the small point is cupping the chin. And we're going to move out right on that jawline. Go to the ear, flip down, towards the upper part portion of the clavicle. Here, pushing out, behind the ear, moving down to the upper portion of the clavicle. Again, this goes 5 to 10 times. go to the lip area. Again, transitioning from here to here, moving outward under the zygomatic to the middle of the ear, manipulating down above the clavicle. Today I would show basic movements, how you can adapt Gua Sha with a facial massage, and it's very effective, it's very beneficial for the skin as far as to repair and recover and restore its natural balance, to de-stress the skin. Educator on Gua Sha. She's very good. And that's something that if you want to advance your knowledge with lymphatic stimulation and the technique of Gua Sha for facial Gua Sha, it's a good class to take. A lot of the classes are online, so you can go to skinforlife.com. Actually go to LouisianaSkinForLife.com and see a large variety of classes that may interest you. So now we're going to do the eye area. So actually now we're going to move in, around, flip, press, one, two, three. Three times at the temple, transition, and then move down behind the ear, around the front, above the clavicle. So we're using this pumping movement where it goes in towards the nose, you flip the stones, pump, one, two, three. Move down towards the temple. Side, and then move. And let's try that again. So you want to go around using a flat, a large flat end towards the nose. Flip, one, two, three. Glide. You see how I use the V to the brow and then temple. So you here's your diamond. Once you put the Gua Sha stones together, you're going over the top of the brow, the forehead. Remember at the temple, we press 1, 2, 3. Transition to the flat piece of the Gua Sha stone. Go behind the ear, in front, above the clavicle, and press. Going over the brow bone, pumping, 1, 2, 3, transition, behind the ear, behind the SCM, on the SCM, in front, and above the clavicle. So now we're going to take our stones and hook them together on one final movement for the forehead. Now there's many different advanced movement that Kristen shows you in the class, so it might be a good idea to maybe look into the class. And she does have online classes, but today I thought I would just show you basic movements that we use in and for lymphatic drainage with a facial massage that you can incorporate using both affirming type of massage and then finishing with Gua Sha stone lymph drain. Final movement, remember it's 5 to 10 passes. 1, 2, 3. And now to complete the lymph drainage, going to do again, finish off with the neck and move down in front. We're going to finish our last 5 movements at the neck area because that's how we started, so that's how we want to finish. Completely flush and drain that area using lymph assist. Just like how I showed you with using your hands for manipulation to first start with the firming massage before you use your Gua Sha stones, you can use your Gua Sha stones for those firming movements that I showed you with my hands. For example, if you wanted to use shorter movements, using upward movements around the cheekbone, so you can use Gua Sha stones for lifting movements to really elevate the cheekbone area, the masseter area, smooth out the rosoris and the buccinator area. So it's good practice to try to lift and pulsate and move the lymph with your Gua Sha stones. So if you do have certain concerns with your hands and thumbs and certain digits, that you're not comfortable using more of those firming movements that I showed you, then use your Gua Sha stones to actually lift and hold and drain and move. So that's just a little tidbit, because I know some estheticians, they have told me that their thumbs, their digits might be a concern to do those particular type of movements. Gua Sha stones are great for this. This is why we pick these certain shape and size of Gua Sha stone, because you can get under the muscle and you can really lift and move and drain all at the same time. So thank you for your time. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration, and we look forward to seeing you again.